I think there's something really unique about how sweet Paddington 2 is. Many children's movies try to have a main character that's cool and hip, or maybe they're sassy and rebellious and kind of a dick. Or on the other end, a lot of these films come off as didactic, but low-key promote some problematic content. Lion King's Lion Supremacy, Sky High's Eugenics, Zootopia's bumbling race allegory that actually implies race science and credible fault to the oppressed. Oh wow, if these were repeated behavior, I'd be concerned. But Paddington Bear actually just lives by a code of being nice. He doesn't revel in his antagonist's downfall. He's just a sweet bear being the change he wants to see in the world. His philosophy is best summarized by a phrase passed down to him by his Aunt Lucy. If we are kind and polite, the world will be right. To summarize the first film, Paddington is a rare species of bear native to Peru, capable of speech and just as much cognitive ability as a Homo sapien. He is made a refugee after an environmental catastrophe strikes his rainforest home. He then travels to England, where he adopts his signature dresswear, the name Paddington after Paddington Square, and goes to live with the Brown family. He eventually wins their hearts and the acceptance of the community. Also, he and his people really like marmalade. Paddington 2 sees the titular bear framed for a massive theft charge by washed-up actor and Supreme Theater major Phoenix Buchanan.
A handsome devil, isn't he? Hmm? Dazzling eyes.
He is for sure queer-coded, but Hugh Grant has so much damn fun in this role.
Thank you. Blessings upon you all. Deepest advice. Thank you.
I know what you're thinking, Scrooge.
Anyway, this fiasco lands Paddington in prison, where his ignorance accidentally riles some of the other inmates. However, after introducing the cook, Knuckles, to his homemade marmalade, Paddington earns the right to join the kitchen staff, after which he initiates a shift in the overall prison culture towards something more collective. Yes, that's right. Paddington Bear creates solidarity amongst inmates by sharing food and subsequently fostering community programs. This is a family movie version of prison, with no racial gangs or inmates screaming about fresh fish, but it is depicted as a place for hardened men who have committed serious crimes. And this is all made possible because of Paddington's adorable purity slash naivety. He treats his fellow inmates like he would neighbors on the outside. He never projects a sense of superiority because he is unjustly imprisoned while they are guilty. Paddington doesn't make assumptions about their crimes. He doesn't even ask about them. He just starts the dessert circle.
It's all right, Mr. Brown. This is my friend, Knuckles.
How are you?
And this is Phibbs.
G'day.
Spoon.
Hello.
Jimmy the Snitch.
All right.
T-Bone.
Watch out.
The Professor.
Hope.
Squeaky Pete.
Hello.
Double Bass Bob.
Hello.
Farmer Jack.
Hello.
Mad Dog.
Oof.
Johnny Cashpoint.
Ka-ching.
Sir Geoffrey Wilcott.
I hope I can rely on your vote.
And Charlie Rumble.
And after winning the trust of his fellow inmates, advocating for a much more tightly knit, healthier prison community, open to recreational activities that bring them together, Paddington's crew invites him to join their prison break. Paddington doesn't dissuade them from escaping, either. He doesn't preach morals about serving their sentence. He understands that remaining under the harsh conditions of the prison is not a fate any of these men deserve. He helped better the conditions of the prison from within, but life in prison is still prison. He's only originally opposed to the escape because he trusts the Browns to aid in his acquittal. However, fellow inmate Knuckles warns him not to place too much hope in his family, as he too once had visitors on the outside. But over time, their visits slowed, until he came to the point of feeling abandoned by those on the outside. After the Browns miss a visit while investigating Phoenix Buchanan, Paddington fears Knuckles may be right and decides to join the prison break. When the crew goes back on their promise to help Paddington prove his innocence, Paddington is hurt, but he doesn't throw out any moralizing condescension. Their only option, after all, is to flee the country entirely.
We go back down there, they won't just lock us up, they'll throw away the key.
I know, but he's our friend.
Of course, Paddington and the Browns eventually reunite and clear his name. The prison crew also risk their safety to come to his aid as promised. And at the end, Knuckles and the others are pardoned. not found to not be guilty all along. They really did commit some crime, but they're given the remainder of their lives back. Phoenix Buchanan ends up in prison, and yeah, on a larger scale, I wouldn't teach my children that violent punishment is justice. However, the film doesn't show us images of Phoenix suffering. It doesn't make some prison joke, there's no shot of prisoners taking revenge on behalf of Paddington. Phoenix actually finds a positive outlet for his theatricality. He's the leading part in a musical. It's a funny sequence and all, but it suggests he gets to turn a new leaf.
Well, it seems I didn't need the West End after all. Just a captive audience. What am I like? Guards, lock me up! The weight you have!
More importantly, the film never gives us the impression that prisoners deserve to be stripped of humanity, trudging from their cold, dark cells to a plate of slop and back again. I'd love a film that teaches kids full-on prison abolition, but Paddington 2 at least gives a sympathetic portrayal of the incarcerated. Paddington 2 depicts prisoners who can live morally, who have their own grievances, and who are extended kindness by the protagonists. It's not only be polite to people who've never been convicted of a crime, or to people who were nice to you first. Be polite, and recognize that other people, even those who committed crimes, have had their own lives and hardships.
And as for that bearded baboon in the middle, he's hardly got two brain cells to rub together.
We can still hear you, Mr. Brown.
Oh, yeah.
That was the light you turned off.
The microphone is on the other side. It's got
microphone written on it.